Francis Opita, 45, has for the last 5 months selflessly nursed his 8-year-old, Eric Odong, who is admitted at Uganda Cancer Institute in Mulago and is battling cancer. Opita shares the struggles of caring for his bedridden son.
20th September, I'm now here for 5 months taking care of my child, by the name Odong Eric, which is suffering from cancer. As you can see, I'm taking care of him as if needed. For the challenges that we are getting here, sometimes we have no things like to eat new food from here just to survive, not to satisfy. So we are lacking something like support of money.
Cancer being a chronic disease, it takes a long care and treatment period. As a result, patients give up while their caregivers suffer burnouts. Dr. Gary Gafadil, a child oncologist and hematologist at Uganda Cancer Institute, explains what comprises holistic care and why it is an important pillar.
Care is actually the most important pillar in taking care of populations of patients with cancer. Cancer treatment, unlike other diseases, is it's a long-duration treatment. It involves both direct and indirect challenges. For example, the pathway to cancer treatment starts with appropriate diagnosis. When patients undergo diagnosis, then they go through treatment. And the journey is divided into two at that point. Treatment may end up into cure. Somebody gets cured of the disease, then has to go through what we call survivorship. Or the patient may fail to get cured for whatever reason, and the patient has to be palliated to create a comfortable life across the remaining part of his or her life.
Dr. Geriga further notes that cancer care and treatment require diagnostic counseling so as to know what to expect along the journey.
The important thing is preparing them to that particular activity. For example, if somebody is going to initiate cancer treatment, they are educated. There's what's called diagnostic talk. Diagnostic talk is a point where the doctor sits down, explains in a very simple language what the disease is, how far the disease spread in the body, and how it's going to be treated. And also explain the immediate side effects, the intermediate side effects, and the long-term side effects that the patient can experience. And also explains how these side effects will be mitigated if possible. So in other words, the patient is prepared aforetime that he or she is going to experience some side effects.
Cancer patients require a well-balanced diet packed with plenty of fruit and vegetables to boost immunity, proteins to build and replace damaged cells, and carbohydrates to provide energy. Nutrition plays an integral part in holistic care and treatment for cancer patients, as Joseph Semuju, a nutritionist at Uganda Cancer Institute, explains.
The holistic approach for these patients, I think, yes, is the best approach for them, and in particular nutrition is part of it, because as our patients go through their cancer journey, a lot of things happen right away from diagnosis. This is a very stressful diagnosis to receive. People get stressed up, and all these will also impact on their nutrition. With that stress, the appetite alone goes down. Somebody feels not interested in all the surroundings, including food. So at that point, nutrition care should also immediately come in.
Semuju says that the side effects of active treatment, such as chemotherapy, should be taken care of.
Now, in particular, when you talk about chemotherapy, you realize these are the chemical drugs we use to treat the disease, but as they perform the job of killing these cancer cells, you realize that they will also damage a number of cells, a number of normal cells, and this leads to a number of side effects. And most of the side effects can also be taken care of through nutrition.
Some cancer patients who are terminally ill will also require to undergo palliative care.
For the patients who cannot be cured, then they undergo an arm which is called palliation. And in that case, a patient must go through the remaining life with zero suffering, both physical and emotional. So in the hospital, we can do good pain control, we can support with antibiotics, we can support with the fluids and blood products, but the patient also needs spiritual support, counseling, psychosocial support. Some of them even need to be engaged in occupational therapy.
Margaret Okello, a breast cancer survivor for 16 years, explains why psychosocial support is very critical in treating cancer patients.
Another thing is some patients lose some parts of their bodies. For instance, breast cancer patients, when they remove their breasts, they feel stigmatized. They lose self-confidence and self-esteem. So this helps that they need to really get someone to talk to them and also to replace what they have lost. It won't be a real breast, but it will be an artificial breast. But if you put it on, you'll feel renewed.
It is important for caregivers to be equipped with appropriate information regarding the caring for cancer patients.
Appropriate information packages that we give the patient and the appropriate information that we give the caretakers, and so that the caretakers must know what to expect along the journey and how to care for this patient. One of the critical things to emphasize about to the caretakers is the need for appropriate and good nutrition. Most of the cancer treatments, especially chemotherapy, tends to destroy a lot of normal body cells, which needs to be rebuilt, and that can only be achieved through appropriate nutrition. So information about nutrition, information about hygiene, information about quick health-seeking behavior in case of any complication is well packaged and given to the caretakers of the
family. Uganda registered a total of 34,000 new cases in 2020, according to the GlobalCAN 2020 report. Last year alone, a total of between 7,000 to 8,000 new cancer patients were registered at the Uganda Cancer Institute in Mulago, while about 1,200 new patients were recorded at Mbarara Regional Referral Hospital. Among women, cancer of the cervix is top on the list of the commonly diagnosed cancers, followed by breast cancer, then cancer of the stomach, cancer of the esophagus, and lastly, cancer of the liver. In men, prostate cancer ranks first, then cancer of the liver and lymphoma, cancer of the soft tissue. Report compiled by Agnes Chotalengeride for the news.